And just like that, the next episode has begun. Welcome back to Ghost Trick Fan Detective. I'm here to make sure if this is like a video, it's like a commentary. And boy, was this draining. You might be wondering, hey, what are we doing over here? Apparently this is a checkpoint, so, you know, if we fail again, we can just go back right here. But anyway, I've pretty much figured out the solution. Pretty much. And when I say pretty much, I don't really mean pretty much. I really mean that, no. No, we actually got pretty close. I was actually intending to finish this off-screen simply because of how long it took to get through all this, but I don't know. It's been 16 minutes real-time since I finished... Not 16 minutes. It's been 14 minutes real-time since I finished the previous episode, so... Yeah, that's kind of put things into perspective how long I've spent on this. This is freaking annoying! Because, like, it just is. I've always been really bad at, like, stealthy stuff like this. But it's alright. Anyway, since I know what to do, I'll be able to continue that story that I was talking about 8,000 years ago. I'm sure you guys remember, it's a really great story about a man and his rodent and... I don't know where I was going with that. In my head, that sounded a lot funnier than it actually was, but you know, that's how it is for a lot of things I see in my videos. Anyway, that story that I was talking about, so... I remember, like, an episode ago, you know, it was felt like so long ago, you know, just yesterday, I was like, oh... Actually, first of all, where's the other guard? I need to figure out where the other guard is and then time my stuff accordingly. Because what I want to do is I want to wait for this guard to go back up. Like, on his way back up, that's when I want Jowd, because we need to get Jowd inside of this, whatchamacallit. Anyway, the story, inside of this vent. So the story was that,
I was like, what if I gave Jowd this pussy?
Okay, so, during the day that I was recording that megacast with Garkon and Kratos, we got on the subject of, like, all the different voices I did for, like, Ace Attorney and everything, and, all the different voices I did for Ace Attorney and everything. Okay. Ring the bell. Call you. You're gonna get fixated on that. So then what we're gonna do is go here. Well, actually, we're gonna need to wait. We need to wait for this guy to cross. Okay, finish crossing, man. I'm waiting for you. What's this hole? There we go. Now we're gonna open this. I think my timing is off. I think my timing might be off on this. I don't know. Now, we have to be quick about this. We have to call Jowd here. Jowd, go, 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 go. Dude, man, use your freaking acrobatic skills in BOP right now, because I really need it. I really... Okay. I almost missed my chance there, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go ahead and close this. So anyway, we were talking... So, like, Garkon was yelling at me for how I gave, like, Lady Von Karma, you know, the German accent. Like, oh, this is Lady Von Karma, Mr. Phoenix Wright, how dare you! And he's like, oh, you didn't need to give it to him, because, like, she grew up in America and everything. She didn't need a German accent. Despite the fact that, actually, I have a viewer from Germany who liked the fact that I gave him... Or gave her a German accent, so whatever. But anyway, then he was talking about how I didn't give Edgeworth an English accent, because apparently Edgeworth is apparently... British, apparently. Like, he grew up in the US and everything, and I gave him an American accent, you know, the Edgeworth voice. Yeah, that's right, I gave the Ray of Light this voice in this series, but, anyway, they showed us, while I was talking to Garkon and Kratos about this, like, apparently there's, like, this scene, you know, let me call him here, there's, like, this scene in the professor, oh, he's going back and you're not supposed to do that! You're not supposed to go in back inside the valve! You didn't do that before- Oh, he's not going inside the valve. For some reason, I thought he was going back inside the valve. I was about to be really mad. Anyway, so, what was I talking about? Oh, yeah! So in the Professor Layton, Professor Layton Phoenix Wright crossover game, yesterday crossover, they showed a scene of, like, Edgeworth and Phoenix duking it out in court, and, for some reason, they followed with, like, Edgeworth being British thing, gave him an English accent, and it was quite hilarious, actually. Just, because, I don't know, like, whenever I picture, like, Ace Attorney characters, I picture usually the voices that I gave them, for the most part. Okay, so, I think I know what I need to do. Okay, I usually picture like the voices that I gave like the Ace Attorney characters. Oh, okay, yeah, that's it. That's what I need to do. Let me open this back up. I need to open this back up so that we mess up his line of sight, or so that he falls down. What I'm gonna need to do? So we need to go to the bell and distract the other guy once this guy falls down. Mm-hmm. So yeah, they gave him an English accent and everything, and it was just ridiculous. It was ridiculous going, you know, I'm just used to this. You know, be quiet already. You want a quarter inch crate? I can do that in 2 seconds flat. Versus, cut the chit chat, right? How I missed that little drivel of yours. Cut the chit chat. No, that's not what he sounded like, but they might as well have made him sound like that because it was freaking ridiculous. I don't. Did you fall down yet? I'm not quite sure. Did I open this? I did. But I waited too late, didn't I? I waited too long. Oh, well, I'm just gonna wait for him to fall down, then I'm gonna call the other guy to the bell, and then we're gonna call him up to the toilet, and then things will be good. That'll be the end of this silly little mini-game. Cut the chit-chat, right? Oh, man, that was freaking ridiculous. Because, like, apparently, yeah, I believe that Edward is supposed to be, like, English or British. Okay, yeah, he fell down, okay. Now what we're gonna do, ring the bell. We actually don't need to ring the bell now that I think about it. We don't need to do that, because, like, that's because the other guy can't see us anyway. But it's alright. Now we're gonna call you over to the toilet. Call. Go. Zhao. Dude, you're gonna see just how freaking flexible Zhao is. He's freaking amazing. Look at this. Boom! Yeah, like, okay, if I move now, yeah. I wish I was that acrobatic. That'd be amazing. But no, I'm just dumb old me. I can't do anything like that. Okay, go inside of this. Now. Okay. Go. You need to go, man. Like, you have no freaking. Okay. Now I'm gonna go inside it. Talk. Here we go. I feel a little uncomfortable out in the open like this. I bet you do. You're wide open. Well, could you lead me to somewhere safe then? The guards can't help but notice me where I am now. Okay. Well, I'm trying to, man. I really am trying, but oh man, I thought I had it. Cause they said, oh, from here we can make a run for it, or No, I don't want to talk to you right now. Where else are we supposed to connect to? Let me try going this way then. Oh no. Did I mess things up? I think I might have messed things up, Laser Gnomeman. Let me open this up again. Yeah. I'll check it out later. Yeah, we're busted. We are so busted right now. Like, you have no idea. It's like the song. That early 2000s boy band song. Okay, go, go, okay. Actually, now that I think about it, I might have actually messed myself up even more now. Yeah, I think... I didn't need to do this. Okay, whatever. It's no big deal. Busted. I'm busted. Why did you reset the dome, man? I'm done. Ladies and gentlemen, my goose is cooked. I'm gonna have to make a frickin' cut. It's kinda ridiculous right now. Yeah, we're caught. There he is! I'm not letting you guys sit through that all over again, so I'm gonna have to make a cut. Again, we came all that way, we were so close. Oh, man. Alright, I'll be right back. Okay, so, I'm back. I spent like a long time until I figured out that what I was doing was actually the wrong thing. I need to get him under the bed. Now we're pretty much done here, actually, apparently. So what we need to do here is, remember at the very beginning, or towards in the previous episode, what I need to do was like how I opened the door and then got the guard distracted by falling down the trap door. Yeah, we actually need to do that. Now we actually need to do it. So let's play the drums. Get him out, fall down, and then apparently, like, the chapter will be basically over at this point. So, you know, I better hope that I don't mess this up. Knock on wood, I don't mess this up. Let's just get you to the electric guitar. Jowd, go. Roll. He's like a roll cake. He's shaped like a roll cake. Okay, and then from here, what we can do is... I get it. Let me close this. I get you, Jowd. I understand you, Jowd. I've been there before. So let's close. And now... Now, just wait for it. Just go under the bed. Okay, so I think we did it. Maybe. I don't know. I'm not quite sure if we're out of the woods just yet. So, what do you think? I'd say if we come this far, we did it! Great job, Sissel! The basement generator has been repaired, restoring power to all areas! Oh no. Did we do it? Maybe? Oh, did we... You better run, man! Get out of here! Ugh, we just made it! But the question is, what now? I don't have anywhere to go, do I? Maybe I'll go back to my cell. You better be kidding! But I'm still a condemned criminal, you know. I doubt anybody'd welcome me with open arms. Why don't you try contacting Lynn? She went to see some Justice Minister guy. So an escaped death row convict is supposed to just report into the Justice Minister, is that it? I kind of like that. Anyway, after all the trouble you went through, I guess I'd better run. That would be nice, yes. Alright, sis, so until we meet again. Frickin' Apparently, Chapter 9, which is the chapter that we just did, apparently that was a really tough chapter for a lot of people, so it wasn't just me who was having trouble with that, but also apparently a Chapter 15 is supposed to be difficult. I'm not quite sure why, but I saw on the GameFAQs forums like, oh yeah, it took me a while to get to Chapter 9, now I'm stuck on Chapter 15, so... I don't know. So now I saved a condemned criminal's life and helped him escape. Was that really the right thing to do? I guess all I can do is believe in Lynn at this point. Detective Jowd was painting my picture in his cell. He knows me. I'm sure I'll be talking to him again. Now everything's nice and peaceful and cha. That was a pain. That chapter was annoying. I started, the recording has been going on for an hour, 3 minutes, and 24 seconds. Now, with all the cuts I'm going to make, I think I should have about 7 minutes left in this episode, and then I'll have to split and do the second half. Why? Anyway, 9 is usually my lucky number, but not in this case. Nothing left but an empty cell. No sense in staying here. I might as well go back. Back upstairs using an internal phone. Yeah, now we can actually, now that we don't have to worry about frickin' Jowd going anywhere. I kind of want to eat a roll cake now, ladies and gentlemen. That made me want to eat a roll cake. That's just a random question. Have you ever had a roll cake before? Those are good. They're actually really easy to make, too. The mortuary. No, we're going to go to the guard room. So, actually, apparently... Okay. But Detective Jowd's Until We Meet Again came around quicker than I expected. When I got back to the guard room, the next fateful call came in. Oh, boy. But anyway... Because they're, I mean, this is... Hello, this is... Oh, jeez. Okay, anyway. So apparently you guys like the fact that I compared these guards to Garkon and Kratos. Well, all of you except for Kratos, anyway, who didn't say anything. I can just see it right now. Wait, you said something about you compared him to us? Yes, I did. That's what happens when you play at 2x speed and... goof around on Twitter while watching my videos. You missed random text annotations. Where was I? I'm just joking around, but seriously, yeah. Anyway, Sissel, are you there? Hello, who's this? Oh, I'm not talking to you, officer. Anyway, if you're there, Sissel, come here immediately. I'll be waiting for you. If you make it in time, that is. Hey, wait a minute! What is, let me guess, Lynn is dead again? Lynn is dead again. That's what happened. Where are we now? You got a new phone number. KMR3243. Oh, man. Watch! Oh, no, they have something to say before we continue. Let's see what Garkon and Kratos have to say now. Detective Bailey and whatever. Anyway.
That call! Who was it from?
I don't know. Some weird call.
Ah, but who? We'll call an end to my dancing!
Yeah, well, once you get going like that, I'm not gonna stop ya.
It's a contest, then! Which will stop first, my dancing or the turning of the planet?
Oh, boy.
Yeah, good luck with that.
Jeez, alright, let's just go ahead and go to the next place where Lynn probably died again. I'm calling it right now, Lynn's probably dead again. Okay, KMR3243.
Jeez, man, I tell you.
Watch, Lynn probably, like, she probably, like, was, like, driving or something, and then, like, a lightning bolt came and blew up her car, and then, like, anyway, what do we have here?
On the other end of the telephone line, the scene that greets me tells me one simple fact.
Oh! Okay, nope, Lynn is not dead, but this is interesting.
That our greatest escape plan has ended in failure.
Never expected to see you here, Inspector Cabanella.
I believe that's my line, my old friend.
What were you doing here?
I believe that's my line too, clearly. I came to attend your execution. They told me what time it was. Couldn't get into the chamber, so I was observing a moment of silence here. And when I looked up, my eyes full of tears, there you were, baby.
It's just the way things turned out. I took part in what seemed like a fun game, and here I am.
Here's what I wish, my old friend. Wish it was anybody but me who found you here. Cause now that I found you, man, I have to turn you in.
You have to stay spotlessly clean after all.
Alright. Well, okay, no, Sissel has something to say. What do you have to say this time, Sissel?
There's a certain something between these two. Is it a warm something or is it cold? Whatever it is, it's immeasurably deep. I should probably see what Detective John has to say.
Yeah. Oh, new track, by the way. Hold on. It's kind of messed up because of the recording, but that's always how it is. Alright, let's talk.
Thanks for coming. I wanted to say goodbye to you. As you can see, I guess I'm not going to be much help to you.
What's going to happen to you?
Being executed tonight is just about the only thing on my schedule, it seems.
Executed, huh?
Death is pretty much meaningless to me. Anyway, I guess we'll be seeing each other again.
By the way, there's something I'm looking for.
Oh, that's right, your lost memory.
You know things I'd like to know. Would you mind if I ask you a few questions?
In return for tonight's fun little game, is that it?
Okay, I think we'll ask questions, though, in the next episode. We're not going to start the awkward pause just yet, because I don't want to start it, like, too early or anything. Like, with all the cuts and everything, I'm really not quite sure how long this is going to be. But, oh, okay, well, whatever the case would be, though. Yeah, about Sissel, about Cabanella execution, I think we'll have an awkward pause right about now?
Sure.
Yeah. Why do I always do that? I always do that now when I do an awkward pause now, though. Thing. Whatever.